Hi friends, welcome back to The Humble Therapist. Today, we are going to talk about stigma versus sensitivity. Thank you so much for joining me today. I know it's been a while since I posted a video and I do apologize for that unannounced hiatus, but it does feel very good to be back. And considering it's Mental Health Awareness Month, I thought it was appropriate that we have a conversation about mental health stigma. Now, this conversation, really the idea for it, was prompted when I was recently filling out medical forms. And as I got to this section where it asked about my mental health history, I paused. And as a mental health provider myself, I really was kind of confused about why I had stopped. I know I have a diagnosis and I know I've been in treatment for it, yet I was still hesitant to fill out that little bit of information. So, being the introverted self-analyzer that I am, I went out to investigate what was behind this pause for me. And I realized that there were a lot of thoughts that went through my mind in those few seconds before I wrote anything down. You know, it had to do with blame, judgment, fear. I was very fearful. I was fearful of being blamed for this diagnosis, of being judged. Like, what if I'm not good enough all of a sudden? What if I'm not capable? And I wrote down in the occupation that I'm a licensed clinician and yet I have a diagnosis. And what if I don't appear to be managing it? You know, so there was a lot of fear about what people would think of me, if I would be blamed for it. And, you know, if you have a diagnosis, you may relate to some of these thoughts. And so this really did get me thinking into, well, what can we do about it? You know, how can we start to fight back mental health stigma in a way that is natural and educational and that feels good to us? Now, I may not have all the answers, but I did realize that we need to foster an increased sense of mental health sensitivity. And to me, sensitivity is the opposite of stigma. So how do we do this? You know, how do we go about even trying to be more sensitive? And there's a few pointers that maybe came from that nasty train of thought that I got before I shared about my diagnosis. And it's, first of all, you know, let's avoid the blame game. We would not blame someone who was born with a congenital heart disease or diabetes for having those conditions. So let us not blame someone who was born with schizophrenia or depression. Also, instead of judging someone who appears to have a mental health diagnosis or who we think are not living up to standards, let's try to insert understanding in that situation. We do not know all that is going on for this person, and I can assure you that this person is doing the best they can with what they have. And finally, instead of that fear, let's try to be more open. And what do I mean by open? I mean fostering a sense of openness in the sense that we become willing to talk about it. Even if we are scared, let's do it anyway. Let's have those conversations. In fact, since a few months back, I've been really trying to insert the fact that I have a mental health diagnosis and the fact that I have been in treatment for it and more of my daily conversations. So outside of the therapeutic setting, me, Priscilla, I am talking about this. And in having these conversations with people, I know that a handful of them have come back and told me that because of this conversation, they sought help. You do not have to be a therapist to talk about mental health. In fact, to many of these people, I was just a friend, a family member, or even a stranger on the street. But the fact that we were able to talk about it spurred them to action and spurred them to seek help and to seek the treatment that they deserve. So I believe that the more that we are able to do this as a community, as someone who has been affected by a mental health diagnosis, now you may or may not have one, but you may know of someone who does, or you may be wondering if, you know, some of the things that you've been feeling have to do with a mental health illness. It is okay to talk about this. It's okay to reach out, and it is okay to get help. The more that we talk about it, the more people are aware of it. And then those of us who do experience an illness feel less alone. I know that we can do this together, and I invite you to practice this week talking about mental health, even if you only mention it one time. See what happens. It may go awesome or it may go terribly wrong. I don't know. But we will definitely continue this conversation in the comments below, on my blog, thehumbledtherapist.blog, or on my social media accounts. If you want to share with me your story and your experiences, I will be there ready to listen and to provide feedback. I know that together, we can defeat stigma by increasing sensitivity.